Hey, what's up guys, it's Kausubh here, and today guys, as per the title and thumbnail of this video, yes, I will be giving you my first impressions of the Open Beta 1 based upon Android 11 for the OnePlus Nord. So right now I have flashed Open Beta 1 on my OnePlus Nord right here, and today I will be giving my first impressions. So do watch the complete video till the end guys, and just like always, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below as well as turn the notifications on so that you don't miss my upcoming videos on the OnePlus Nord. With that being said, let's roll the intro and get the video started. So guys, starting with the video, this is the OnePlus Nord right here, and I have currently installed Oxygen OS 11, that is Open Beta 1 for the OnePlus Nord. So I'll just quickly show you that. So as you guys can see here, Android version is Android version 11 that we get. Then security patch is December 1, 2020. So that's the latest that we get. I will just quickly show you this Easter egg as well. It is nothing special, just like a clock of sorts, and yeah, that's about it. So right now we are running on Oxygen OS 11 for the OnePlus Nord. Here you can see the build number as well. Firstly going on is with the UI. So you can immediately see that this settings app is a really controversial thing, because a lot of people didn't like the design initially, like because it mainly looks like one UI guys. Like just in first glance I think it still looks like one UI, but it is something that will grow on you eventually and you will be okay with it. So that's not a big issue. It's really smooth, nothing much to complain about. Also I will just quickly show you the app drawer as well, and everything, like the whole notification panel has also some slight changes here. You can directly see the time right now, and these are all the icons. This is how all of that looks. Also shelf, talking about shelf guys, then this is the new OnePlus shelf that we have got, and it has also been updated with some slight animations, I should say. Weather widget has been added, and yeah, that's for the shelf. And I'll just quickly go back again. So this is the UI, and talking about visual changes, then it is mainly with system apps. So in calculator you can see it has been revamped a bit. Then going on to the clock app, also clock app has also been changed a bit. Here we can see that. Talking about a dialer, then still we get the Google dialer for some reason, I don't know, but we still get the Google dialer and not the OnePlus dialer. Messages app is also the Google messaging app. Camera UI has also seen some changes. You can see the camera shutter button has been changed, portrait mode, nightscape, and everything other than that is pretty same. But camera UI has been changed a bit. Going on to the gallery here, gallery has also been again changed. So this format is like a story format, and as you keep on clicking pictures, it will show you all the pictures and video in a story format, just like Instagram stories. So this is how the gallery looks guys. Gallery is also pretty sleek and pretty smooth, I would say. No issues whatsoever in the gallery app. So that's about it for the main system and for the visual changes that we get. Going on to the features, then in settings, if we go into the display here, into ambient display guys, then in ambient display these are some new settings that we get to see here. Horizon light is the new feature that we get to see. Like whenever you will get a notification, the display will light up from the edges, as you can see in the animation right here. So that's a cool thing which has been added now. Other than that, you also get the option to schedule ambient display, so you can set a specific time or you can set it to all day as well, and it will work absolutely fine. Other than that, the display settings are almost the same. Vision comfort is something like a reading mode, I would say, like it is like a night mode of sorts. Going into the customization, then the new feature which is there is the canvas feature that tapping on the display here. You can see that outline faint, and then whenever you will unlock, this is how it will unlock, and it looks really cool for some reason. So guys, after the canvas feature that I showed you just now, the next new feature that we get is this ambient display styles. So we get a lot of new clock designs here. Some of them are old ones only, but some of them are new, especially this one. So this one was specifically introduced in the OnePlus 8T, and now we get it on the OnePlus Nord. So it's really a cool clock design. I will just apply it and will show you guys as to how it looks. It is a really faint display guys, you can't really that much see that much. It's really on low brightness in ambient display mode to save battery, but it's there. So that's the new thing. And after that, going on to the dark mode. So in dark mode now we get a toggle here, so you can see just by pressing that toggle it will trigger dark mode and everything will go dark. So that's a nice addition. And also, if we click on that toggle, you get the option to schedule dark mode. So this was a missing feature from a long time in OxygenOS, but finally now we have got that option to schedule dark mode as to our liking. Cool animations which I noticed, I think, are really cool is with the selfie camera. So whenever the selfie camera is turned on, it will show a cool animation. So guys, right now, as you saw, I have talked about all the new features that you get in open beta 1 for the OnePlus Nord. And guys, if you are someone who already owns the OnePlus Nord and you're very tempted to flash the open beta 1, then let me remind you that guys, it is a beta stage software, so it will have some sort of bugs and battery life wouldn't be the best. So keep that in mind and then only flash open beta 1, otherwise you might encounter some issues in the system. So I wouldn't recommend you to try this out unless and until you know what you're doing. But other than that, if you ask me my opinion, then I'm really impressed with OxygenOS 11. At first, when I saw it in the leaks and rumors, everybody was talking like it is so similar to that of Samsung's One UI, but that's the case only in the settings app, I would say. Other than that, I think the whole UI is pretty stock till now also. And there have been some additions of some useful features in the OxygenOS UI as well. So overall, I really liked the open beta 1 for the OnePlus Nord, and this was my first time actually experiencing OxygenOS 11 on an official OnePlus device. So overall, I'm pretty impressed. And also, this was not my full review of this open beta version, so this was just my initial impressions. So I will do a detail and in-depth testing of this one, and also will put out the full review so that you guys can determine as to how good this open beta is and whether you can try this or not. Because any which ways, the stable version of this Android 11 OxygenOS 11 will be coming soon via an OTA update to all the OnePlus Nord users. So yeah, that's about it guys, and this was my initial impressions of the open beta 1 for the OnePlus Nord. And if you have liked it, then please do hit the like button down below, as well as guys, do get subscribed to my channel, because a lot of OnePlus Nord videos are coming to the channel really really soon. With that being said, this is your boy Kaustubh here from Tech2Explore signing off. Until then, keep exploring.